Good morning, everyone. How are you all? I hope all of you are doing well. Welcome to mathematics class of grade 8, and this is my lecture number 1 of chapter number 7, cubes and cube roots. So dear children, we are going to start next chapter, that is chapter number 7, cubes and cube roots. So these are the topics which I am going to discuss in this lecture number 1 of chapter number 7, cubes and cube roots. First of all, I will be giving you the brief introduction of this chapter. Next, I will tell you about cube numbers or perfect cubes. What are cube numbers or perfect cubes? Then I will be discussing the properties of cubes of natural numbers. So these are all the topics which I am going to discuss in this lecture number 1. So let us start with the very first topic, that is introduction of cubes and cube roots. In the introductory part of this chapter, I will tell you about Hardy-Ramanujan number. So dear children, what is this Hardy-Ramanujan number? Let us see. I am telling you a short story about this number. Once, one of the India's great mathematical geniuses, S. Ramanujan, he and another mathematician, that is Professor G. H. Hardy, came to visit, whose number was 1729. Hardy described that this number is a very dull number, but Ramanujan quickly pointed that this was indeed an interesting number. He said that this is the smallest number that can be expressed as a sum of two cubes in two different ways. He means that this 1729 can be expressed as the sum of two cubes in two different ways. So let us see now how this number can be expressed. According to Ramanujan, one of the greatest, India's great mathematical geniuses, according to S. Ramanujan, this number is quite interesting. How? Let us see now. 1729 can be expressed as 1728 plus 1. That is the cube of sum of two cubes. This can be written like this. It is 1728 plus 1, and this is the cube of 12. 12 cube is 1728 plus 1 cube. So we will be getting 1729. Another way to express this 1729 is, it can be written as 1000 plus 729. That is, it is equal to 10 cube plus 9 cube. So dear children, you have observed that this number can be expressed as sum of two cubes in two different ways. We have expressed this number 1729 like this, and another way to express this number is this. So this can be expressed as the sum of two cubes in two different ways. So this is quite an interesting number, and that is why this is known as Hardy-Ramanujan Hardy-Ramanujan number. So 1729 is the smallest Hardy-Ramanujan number. There are many infinitely such numbers. Few I am telling you. One of the number can be, it is 4104. This can be written as 2 cube plus 16 cube. Another way of expressing this number is 9 cube plus 15 cube. Likewise, we have many such numbers. But the main number, this 1729, is the smallest Hardy Ramanujan number. I hope this is clear to you. Now, talking about cube. Dear children, you have already learnt about cube in your previous class, that cube is a solid figure which has all the three sides equal. That is, length is equal to breadth is equal to height. So, cube is basically a solid figure in which all the three sides are equal. And volume of cube is given by side cube. So, cube of a number is the product of the number by itself three times. Like I told you that volume of cube is given by side cube, it means you are multiplying side three times. So, if we need to find the cube of any number, then what do I need to do? We are supposed to take the product of the number by itself. It is basically the product of number by itself three times. This is how we can find out the cube of any given number. For example, if I need to find out, the cube of 5, it means 5 cube I need to find out. So this 5 will be multiplied by itself 3 times. So what I am doing? I am taking the product of the number by itself 3 times. So this is quite clear. Next, for example, I need to find the cube of 7. So I will be writing 7 cube is equal to 7 into 7 into 7. So likewise, if you are supposed to find the cube of any number, then what you are supposed to do? You are supposed to take the product of that particular number by itself 3 times. Now, if I talk about 1, 1 cube will be 1. That is equal to 1 into 1 into 1. You will be getting 1. If I talk about 2, that is 2 cube, if I need to take, it will be 2 into 2 into 2, that will be 8. If I need to take the cube of 3, these are the natural numbers I am writing. These are the natural numbers and I am taking their cube this side. So 3 cube is equal to 3 into 3 into 3, that is 27. I am writing this in the form of table. 1, I am taking its cube, 1 cube will be 1. 2, it is 2 cube, that is equal to 2 into 2 into 2, that is equal to 8. If I need to take right 3, 3 cube will be 3 into 3 into 3, that is 27. So, dear children, you can see that 1, 2, 3, these are the natural numbers. The result of after taking the cube, that is 1, 8, 27, these are cube numbers. These are what? These are cube numbers or perfect cubes. You can say these are perfect cubes or these are perfect cubes or cube numbers. So these are the natural numbers 1, 2 and 3, or likewise you can take till 10 also. You can make the table till 10. These are the natural numbers. This side I am taking. This side I am taking the cubes of these natural numbers. So the resultant is known as perfect cube or perfect cubes. Resultants are known as perfect cubes or cube numbers. Now, dear children, all the natural numbers are not perfect cubes. So, dear children, it is not mandatory that the natural numbers given to you are always perfect cubes. So, how will we come to know that the given natural number is a perfect cube or not? For this, we need to do the prime factorization of the number to find out whether the given number is a perfect cube or not. Let us see an example. If I need to do the prime factorization, or if I am writing the number 64 into prime factors, then I will be writing like this. It will be 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. So this 64 can be expressed as the product of, here you can see product of triplets. This is 3 times available with us. This is also available with us 3 times. So this 64 can be expressed as the product of triplets. Here this is present 3 times. This is also present 3 times. So I am using the word triplet. Triplets of equal prime factors. So it is quite obvious that 64 is a perfect cube. So whenever you will do the prime factorization of the given number, then that particular number should be expressed as the product of the triplets of equal prime factors. Now I am taking another example, that is I am taking the number 192. As I told you, I need to do the prime factorization of 192. So I am doing the same. I am doing the prime factorization of 192. So it will be 2, 9 and 6. It will be 2, 4, 8, 2, 24, 2 and this will be 12, 2 and this will be 6, 2. And further it will be 3 and then it will be 3 and this is 1. So you can clearly see that this 2 is present 3 times, this 2 is present 3 times, but this 3 is left unpaired. So as I told you that if a number can be expressed as product of triplets of equal prime factors, then that number is a perfect cube. Here you can see that 3 is left unpaired, so this 192 is not a perfect cube because this cannot be expressed as the product of triplets of equal prime factors. Simple as this. So this is an example that where you can see that 192 is not a perfect cube number. So let us talk about the properties of cubes of natural numbers. Dear children, I think it is clear. What do you mean by cubes of natural numbers? As I have given you one table, like 1 is a natural number, but if I am taking 1 cube that is equal to 1, this resultant is known as perfect cubes or cubes. Likewise, 2 is equal to 2 cube that is equal to 8. So this 8 is known as the cube or perfect cube. These are the cube numbers or perfect cubes. So let us talk about the properties of cubes of natural numbers. Now, as I have told you that 1 cube, if I will be taking the cube of 1, I will be getting 1. 2 cube, I am getting 8. If I need to get the cube of 3, that will be 27. If I am going till further, I am taking the cube of 4, that will be 4 cube is equal to 64. I am doing the cube of 5 now, it will be 5 cube, that is equal to 125. From here, from the table, you can observe that cubes of odd numbers are odd. This 2 is even, this is 8. But the cubes of even numbers, that is 2, answer is even. Cube of 4 is 64. This is again even. Likewise, if you will be taking the cube of 6, you will find also an even number. So, cube of, the very first property is, cube of odd numbers are odd. Cube of even numbers are even. These are the two properties from this table. It is quite clear to you. Continuing with the cube of the numbers till 10, I am writing the cubes of number till 10. That is, 1 is equal to 1 cube. If I am taking the cube, that will be 1. 2 is the natural number. 2 cube is 8. 3 is the natural number. 3 cube is 27. 4 is the number, natural number. 4 cube is 64. 5 is the natural number. 5 cube is 125. 6 is the natural number. 6 cube is 216. 7 is the natural number. 7 cube is 343. 8 is the natural number. 8 cube I am taking, that is equal to 512. Here I am writing. 9 is the natural number. 9 cube will be equal to 729. Then 10 is the natural number. 10 cube will be equal to 1000. As I told you, the very first property you have learned, that if I am taking the cubes of odd numbers, answer will be odd. Cubes of even numbers, answer will be even. Now if you will observe this table, you will find that if a number has 2 in the units place, then its cube ends in 8. Here 2 cube is 8. This is another property. Now if a number has 8, you can see 8. 8 in its units place, then the cube ends with 2. What is the unit digit of this number? 2. So if a number ends with 2, then its cube ends in 8. If a number has 8 in the units place, then its cube ends in 2. If you observe this, 3. If a number has 3 in the unit place, then its cube ends in 7. If a number has 7 in its units place, its cube ends with 3. 2, 8, 8, 2, 3, 7, 7 and 3. Then if a number has 0 in the unit place, then its cube ends in 0. Now the digits ending with 1, 4, these are the leftover digits. I am writing in it in the box. These are the leftover digits. 1, 3 already. Okay, we have done. We have covered 3. 1, 4, 5, 6 and 9. The digits which I have covered in the boxes, you will find that 1, if a number has 1 in the units place, its cube will also end with the same number. 1, 1, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6, 9 and 9. So, if a number has 1, 4, 5, 6, 9 in the units place, then its cube also end with the same digits. You can see here it is ending with 1, it is ending with 4, it is ending with 5, it is ending in 6, it is ending in 7. So I hope, dear children, all these properties are clear to you. Now let us see a very short topic, that is cubes of negative integers. Cubes of negative integers. For example, if I need to find the cube of minus 2, it means I need to multiply this minus 2 3 times. So answer will be minus 8. Minus minus plus plus minus minus. So it will be minus 2 into 2 into 2. That will be 8. So answer will be minus 8. If I need to find the cube of minus 3, this 5 minus 5 is being multiplied by itself 3 times and the answer will be negative minus 125. Now I'm going to discuss NCERT exercise 7.1 questions. Let us talk about question number 1. Question number 1 is, which of the following numbers are not perfect cubes? Few numbers are given to you and you're supposed to find out how many of these numbers are not perfect cubes. As I told you, dear children, to find whether a given number is a perfect cube or not, you are supposed to do the prime factorization of those numbers. I am taking first example. The first number is 216 and I need to do the prime factorization of this 216. So I am doing the prime factorization. It will be 2108, then 254 here, 227, 39, and here it is 33. And then 3, 1. So this 216 can be expressed as 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 3. So it can be expressed as the product of the triplets of equal prime factors. So this 216 is a perfect cube. So you will write it is equal to 2 into 3. That is, so it is a perfect cube. 216 can be expressed as the product of triplets, because 2 is present 3 times, 3 is present 3 times. So it can be expressed as the product of triplets of equal prime factors. So 216 is a perfect cube. Now I am going to discuss fourth part of same question, that is question number 1. It is 100. We need to do the prime factorization of 100. It will be like this. Now you can see this 100 is equal to 2 into 2 into 5 into 5. So this 100 cannot be expressed as the product of triplets. Here 2 is present how many times? 2 times only. But we want it to be present 3 times. Again 5 is present 2 times. But how many times it should be present? 3 times. As it should be expressed as the triplets of equal prime factors. So this is not being expressed as the triplet of equal prime factors. So 100 is not a perfect cube number. Like this you are supposed to write down. Dear children, I have explained two parts of this question. Rest parts you are supposed to do on your own. Now I am going to discuss question number 2. First part I am taking. The question is, find the smallest number by which each of the following numbers must be multiplied to obtain a perfect cube. The very first part is 243. First of all, in these types of questions, you are supposed to do the prime factorization of the given number. Like I am going to do the prime factorization of first. Actually, we need to find out by what number I should multiply this 243 so as to get a perfect cube. So, doing the prime factorization of 243. It will be, I am taking it by 3. 3, it will be 27. 3, 9. Here it will be 3, 3. Then it will be 3, 1. So, this 243 is equal to 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. So again, this cannot be expressed as the product of triplets of equal prime factors. This 3 is present 3 times, but To complete the triplet of these two numbers, we want one more 3. So we are supposed to multiply it. Multiply 243 by 3 so that its triplet gets completed. So 243 should be multiplied by 3. Should be multiplied by 3 so as to get a perfect cube. I am explaining this question again, dear children. Here 243 was the number given to you. You are supposed to do the prime factorization. We have done the prime factorization of 243, and after prime factorization we have seen that triplet, these two numbers are not present in triplet. So we are supposed to complete the triplet of these two numbers, and then for this reason one 3 is required, one more 3 is required. So that is why we need to multiply this 243 by 3 so that it becomes a perfect cube. Now it's time for the homework. Dear children, you are supposed to complete question number 1 to question number 3 of exercise 7.1 in homework notebook. As few parts I have discussed in this lecture, rest of the parts you are supposed to complete yourself, or still if you are unable to do those questions, you can discuss in the online classes also. Though I will be discussing the solutions of these questions in the next lecture, but still if you face any problem, you can resolve your doubts in the online classes. So in this lecture we have learned about Hardy Ramanujan number. What is that number? 1729 is the smallest Hardy Ramanujan number. And after that we have learned about cubes, properties of cubes, what are perfect cubes numbers, how to find whether a given number is a perfect cube or not, and on the basis of these concepts we have discussed few questions. So you are supposed to complete question number 1 to question number 3 of exercise 7.1 in your homework notebook. Dear children, I think you will be capable enough to do all these questions based on the taught concepts in this lecture. Thank you so much.